there are a few different ways that you can add audio fades to your music and sound effects in Premiere Pro. The first way is using the built-in default transitions. The second way is using the pen tool. And the third way is using
auto ducking.
The third way is to use auto ducking using the essential sound panel. So let's first start with the default transitions. Using the built-in audio transitions is the easiest way to do a fade out. Here in my timeline, I have the sequence of hot air balloons from Turkey, and I have this nice music track from Epidemic Sound, and I want it to fade out at the end with the video fade out. So what I can do is I can just go to the out point of the music track and I can control click and select apply default transition. If I zoom into the timeline, you can see it added a constant power transition. Now, if I want to make this longer, because right now it's a little bit short, I can actually roll this out to make it longer. Now, when we play it back, it'll gradually fade out. So if you tend to always make the duration of your transition longer and you want it to default to being longer so that way you don't have to extend it out each time, you can actually go up to Premiere Pro, Preferences, Timeline, and here from Audio Transition Default Duration, you can change this duration. So if you always want it to be 3 seconds instead of 1 second, you can hit OK. So now if I delete Constant Power and apply Default Transitions, it'll default always to 3 seconds. There are 3 different crossfades that you can use. The constant gain, the constant power, and the exponential fade. Constant power is the default because it's generally the smoothest and it just gradually fades out. Constant gain, sometimes the fade can feel a little bit abrupt. That's why a lot of people don't end up using this one. But exponential fade is actually great. I use this one a lot. If you want to change exponential fade to the default, you can control click on it and set selected as default transition. And now it has that blue outline around it as the default. So now that exponential fade is the default, let me show you the difference. Let's play the constant power. Now let's delete that and apply default, and let me show you how that sounds. See how it ends a little bit quicker than the constant power? So I tend to leave exponential fade as my default. And welcome back. My name is Kelsey, and if this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe. And this month, I'm also running a live sound editing and mixing workshop. If you want to register, there's a link just down below. And also a huge thanks to Epidemic Sound for sponsoring today's video. All of the music and sound effects in this video is from Epidemic Sound, and it's completely royalty-free and YouTube-friendly, meaning you won't get any copyright strikes. And the best part is it's unlimited, so you can download as much as you want to try out and play around until your edit is good. For example, with this opening sequence, I downloaded a bunch of car drive-bys and whoosh sound effects to add to the edit to bring it to life. So for example, for this demo edit with the hot air balloons, and I added this here in the timeline. So when the car drives by, whoosh, another whoosh, and another whoosh, and then the car driving off. So Epidemic Sound, if you go there, you can search Premiere Gal and you'll find my playlist of great background tracks for video, but they also have lots of other playlists that you can browse. If you'd like to try Epidemic Sound to get unlimited sound effects and music, you can use my link below to get 30 days free when you sign up for a personal or a commercial plan. All right, so now let's go into the second method of doing an audio fade using the pen tool. To use the pen tool to create fades, first you wanna go to the wrench tool and make sure that show audio keyframes is turned on. So that way on your audio track, if I expand this out, you will see a white line, and that is the volume which we can manipulate. So to add a fade using the pen tool, we can just press P on our keyboard to bring up the pen tool, and then click at the point where you want the fade to start, and then we can click at the end and just bring it down. Now this is a linear fade, so if I play this back, this is what it sounds like. If you want it to be more of a curve, press Command if you're on a Mac or Control if you're on a PC and click on this dot. And then we can move this blue handle to kind of have it not fade out quite as much in the beginning and then exponentially fade at the end. So let's just see how this sounds. So So it's pretty cool. The pen tool gives you a lot of flexibility and you can make as many points as you want if you want to, for example, duck the audio down when there's dialogue, which brings us to the next one, which is auto ducking with the essential sound panel. Auto ducking works best if you need to duck against a different type of audio. So I recorded a little demo voiceover. Now when I play it back, you can hear the audio of the music is a little bit too loud.
Turkey is well known for the panoramic.
So it's a little difficult to hear. What we can end up doing is first select the voiceover clip, go to the essential sound panel, select dialogue, and now Premiere Pro knows that that particular clip we have selected is dialogue. We can auto match it to normalize the audio loudness. And then here at the clip volume, if you need to boost it up a little bit, you can just move this slider over. I'll bring this up a couple decibels. The next thing we need to do is select the music clip. And here we need to categorize it from the essential sound panel as music. This is where it gets cool. We can select ducking, turn this on, and here you can choose to duck it against a particular audio type. Here we're going to choose dialogue. So make sure the little chat bubble is blue if you're using dialogue, and you can adjust the sensitivity. I'll just keep it at the default, and duck amount is how much of a drop it'll go. So minus 18 is the default. It's pretty good. You can always adjust this. And the duration is how long that fade is going to be. So after you hit generate keyframes, you'll see in the timeline that it created these 4 points. And it lowered at the moment that I'm speaking in my voiceover down minus 18 decibels.
Turkey is well known for the panoramic view of hundreds of hot air balloons.
So we may have to adjust the in and out because it's a little bit hot. So here I can go to the beginning and lower this down to like minus 3.8. That way it's not too hot after that transition. But it's a great starting point, right? Because you can just go in and just adjust these auto points that were automatically created. And this will save you a lot of time. All right, so now we can play it back to see the final result.
Turkey is well known for the panoramic view of hundreds of hot air balloons gently ebbing and flowing above valleys in the iconic volcanic formations.
If you want to learn some more cool creative fade outs, for example, how to reverb out or ring out a music track, you can just click right here to watch that video. And if this video helped you out, be sure to subscribe by clicking on my face right here, as well as hitting that notification bell. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.